So hello everyone, and a very good morning to all of you. Welcome back once again to the session of PIB Current Affairs, where we are going to discuss some more questions from the PIB news, which are relevant for all the government exams. But before we begin, I would like to appeal guys कि अगर आप लोग चाहते हैं कि आपके exams time पे हों, तो COVID appropriate behavior जो है उसको follow करें, ताकि COVID कम से कम फैले और आपके exams जो है वो time to time होते रहें, उसमें और ज़्यादा delay ना हो। सभी का एग्जाम 20 फरवरी को होने वाला है, नबार्ड के इंटरव्यू होने वाले हैं, तो ये कहीं ना कहीं हमारी ड्यूटी भी है कि हम कोविड अप्रोप्रिएट बिहेवियर को फॉलो करें एंड अपने आसपास के लोगों को भी मोटिवेट करें टू डू द सेम थिंग्स, सो दैट हमारा जो एग्जाम है वो टाइम से हो एंड नॉट ओनली एग्जाम्स, हम सबकी लाइफ प्रॉपर ट्रैक पे आए एंड सबकी लाइफ अच्छे से आगे बढ़े। ऑलराइट, सो लेट्स बिगिन विद टुडे सेशन, बट बिफोर वी बिगिन डू सब्सक्राइब टू द चैनल एंड प्रेस दिस बेल आइकन इफ यू आर कमिंग हियर फॉर द फर्स्ट टाइम एंड यू कैन जॉइन दिस टेलीग्राम ग्रुप, हियर यू विल गेट द पीडीएफ ऑफ दिस सेशन आफ्टर द सेशन इज कंप्लीटेड विद मार्क्ड आंसर्स एंड यू कैन ऑल्सो आस्क योर डाउट्स हियर, यू कैन ऑल्सो फॉलो मी ऑन इंस्टाग्राम, हियर ऑल्सो यू कैन आस्क एनी डाउट। सो लेट्स टॉक अबाउट द वेरी फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन एंड गाइज आज के सेशन में 5 क्वेश्चन हैं बिकॉज अभी आजकल कुछ बड़ा इवेंट हो नहीं रहा है बिकॉज ऑफ कोविड, तो बहुत ज़्यादा न्यूज़ है नहीं, बट ऑल दीज 5 क्वेश्चंस आर ऑफ कोर्स एग्जाम ओरिएंटेड, सो यू हैव टू फोकस ऑन दीज। इन विच डिस्ट्रिक्ट ऑफ उत्तर प्रदेश इंडियाज फर्स्ट मोबाइल हनी प्रोसेसिंग वैन हैज बीन लॉन्च्ड अंडर KVIC's खादी विलेज एंड इंडस्ट्री कमीशन हनी मिशन, सो इट हैज बीन लॉन्च्ड अंडर हनी मिशन, इट इज क्लियर। सो रिमेंबर KVIC हैज रोल्ड आउट इंडियाज फर्स्ट मोबाइल हनी प्रोसेसिंग वैन्स एट विलेज सिरोरा, डू रिमेंबर नेम ऑफ द विलेज ऑल्सो, विलेज सिरोरा इन गाजियाबाद डिस्ट्रिक्ट ऑफ उत्तर प्रदेश, राइट, गाजियाबाद ऑफकोर्स कम्स अंडर द NCR रीजन एंड रिमेंबर द वैन कैन प्रोसेस एंड इंस्टेंटली एग्जामिन द क्वालिटी ऑफ हनी, ठीक है, ये जो वैन होंगी इनका काम क्या होगा, हनी को प्रोसेस करना और उसकी क्वालिटी को इंस्टेंटली एग्जामिन करना। रिमेंबर इट हैज बीन डेवलप्ड बाय मल्टी डिसिप्लिनरी ट्रेनिंग सेंटर विच इज लोकेटेड एज पंजोखेड़ा एट अ कॉस्ट ऑफ ₹15 lakh and it has been launched under the KVIC's honey mission. Talking about honey mission, so it was launched in the year 2017-18 by KVIC under the Ministry of MSMEs to promote beekeeping activities this mission was launched, all right, and under this mission what happens is that under this program bee boxes toolkits and training are being provided to the beneficiaries to promote the beekeeping activities. So this was regarding the honey mission. Now let's come back to the question. So the correct answer should be option E, Ghaziabad. In Ghaziabad district of Uttar Pradesh, India's first mobile honey processing van has been launched by KVIC. Now moving ahead to question number 2. Which of the following organizations has introduced, designed and implemented the digital embossing technology which is being used to design and develop the braille maps? So braille maps को design करने के लिए एक technology use होती है, digital embossing technology. Question is, which of the following organizations has introduced, designed and implemented this technology? So let's talk about this. Remember, Ministry of Science and Technology has said that visually challenged students will soon have the access to braille maps which are being designed and developed using the digital embossing technology. Now remember, this technology eliminates the need for printing plates, for molds, for chemicals and solvents, it will eliminate all the pollutants or waste and reduces overall energy usage. Now remember, this technology has been introduced, designed and implemented for the first time in India by National Atlas and Thematic Mapping Organization, which works under the Department of Science and Technology. All right. So this was about this news, and that's why the correct answer will be what, option B, National Atlas and Thematic Mapping Organization. Of course, World Braille Day is observed every year on 4th of January. Abhi recently gaya hai. Now moving ahead to question number 3. Where has National Conference of E-Governance 2021 been organized by Department of Administrative Reforms and Public Grievances along with the Ministry of Electronics and IT? Ministry of Electronics and IT is headed by Mr. Ashwani Vaishnav, who is also the Minister of Railways. All right. Now, this National Conference on E-Governance 2021 was organized by Department of Administrative Reforms and Public Grievances and Ministry of Electronics and IT in association with the Government of Telangana. and it was held at Hyderabad. It was the 24th edition and it was held at Hyderabad. The theme was India's Decade: Digital Governance in a Post-Pandemic World. And Hyderabad Declaration was adopted, in which the government of India and the state governments will collaborate together to, you know, enhance the efficiency of the digital ecosystem of the country and thereby improving the e-governance. And during the event, National E-Governance Awards 2021 were also presented. 26 awards were presented under the 6 categories. No need to go into the details of the awardees. Kin kin ko award mila, wo janne ki zarurat nahi hai. This is not important for the exam. So therefore guys, the correct answer will be what? Option A, Hyderabad. Kahan pe organize hua tha? Ye Hyderabad mein. Question number 4 pe chalte hai. Which city in India has become India's first city to have water metro project? And water metro guys is nothing but a boat. Right? It is nothing but a boat. And remember, the first city in India to have a water metro project is Kochi, option C, which is located in Kerala. Remember, this project is a part of 747 crore project which is being implemented by Kochi Water Metro Limited. And the very first boat, or you can say the very first water metro, which has been started under this water metro project is named as Muziris. And the major part of this project, guys, remember, is financed under the Indo-German Financial Cooperation. Alright. So option C, as I already told you the answer, Kochi is the correct answer. And guys, aaj ke session mein jo meri voice hogi wo thodi si distorted hogi, so please cooperate for today because there is some technical issue in my setup and main nahi chahta tha ki session cancel ho. Thoda sa volume ko kam karke aap sunoge to aapko proper better sunai dega. Now let's move ahead to question number 5 for the day. With which state National Dairy Development Board has signed an MOU for dairy development in the state? NDDB is currently chaired by Mr. Minesh Shah, and its first chairperson was Dr. Varghese Kurien. Dr. Varghese Kurien was the first chairperson of National Dairy Development Board. And the question is, with which state NDDB has signed this MOU for dairy development? This state, guys, is Assam. Option D is the correct answer. Alright, so guys, aaj ke question mein bahut zyada details mein hame jaane ki zarurat nahi thi kyunki bahut direct aur bahut hi basic questions the. जनरली हमें डिटेल में तब जाना पड़ता है जब कोई स्कीम बेस्ड क्वेश्चन होता है या कोई इनिशिएटिव बेस्ड क्वेश्चन होता है. ऐसे क्वेश्चंस में यू डू नॉट हैव टू गो इनटू द डिटेल्स. ऑलराइट, सो दैट्स इट फॉर द सेशन. आई विल सी यू इन द नेक्स्ट सेशन ऑन फ्राइडे. थैंक यू सो मच फॉर वॉचिंग. गुड बाय, टेक केयर एंड गॉड ब्लेस.